Yesterday, they played each other in singles. Today, the Williams sisters are in another semifinal as doubles partners. They won the first set 6-3 over Zvereva and Kournikova. And right now, Venus Williams serving down love one to start the second set on service for the Williams sisters. With the call, Ted Robinson and Chris Evert.
Well, the Williams sisters trying to get themselves on track in what has to be an extraordinarily difficult doubles match.
Love 15.
Zvereva, the more probably seasoned player when you consider her credentials. She's won 14 Grand Slam doubles titles with Gigi Fernandez. I think they challenged Martina and Pam as the greatest ever doubles team. And then four more with other partners.
15-0.
Well, you get the sense, Chris, right now they're feeling more like partners than opponents as they were yesterday.
I think they're awfully glad that day is over, as we all are.
Yes.
And now it's business as usual in the Williams family.
30-15.
And Serena already, after watching that first set, looks a lot better than she did yesterday. You know, she just swing freely. She's more consistent. A lot less pressure playing these opponents.
Would this be a good warm-up, in a sense, for Venus for tomorrow?
This is a great warm-up. This is, they don't have to go out and practice. You know, they can just play their doubles. And I remember John McEnroe often said, when people asked him, did you like to practice? He said, no, I hate to practice. That's why I played doubles. That was my practice. But they're communicating. That's the wonderful thing about doubles. You need to communicate. The Williams sisters are always talking to one another and planning out strategy before the next point, whispering, where are you going to serve? She's going to say, I'm serving wide or I'm serving down the middle of the court. Remember, there used to be hand signals. Some players still use that behind their back.
They've had such remarkable success with limited experience in singles, even less experience in doubles, and great success.
Well, you're right, Ted.
Ms. Williams.
They've won two Grand Slam titles last year. They won the U.S. Open, they won the French Open, and they had a great year. But they still very often look like two singles players out there playing at doubles. And it's been good enough because they are powerful. They have some good first serves. They're pretty quick at the net, but they haven't really learned the moves that makes you a great doubles player. You know, when to poach, when to say to stay.
That's how you say they look like singles players, too?
Yes.
Well, Anna Kournikova last year played doubles and extremely successfully with Martina Hingis. They were former juniors rivals, and they teamed up very well, but that pairing broke up this year.
15-0.
Well, she's actually ended up the year the number one player in the world in doubles, which is interesting. She hasn't lived up to her potential in singles yet. I think she's still searching for that high level of play to break her into the top 10. She's obviously the pinup girl in women's tennis, and she's been very good for the game. I mean, she's drawn a lot of attention outside of tennis. Perhaps that's hurt her game in the end because she is doing fashion layouts, and I think she's just in a movie with Jim Carrey. So she's doing a lot of things outside of the court that maybe distracts her from reaching her potential.
30.
But overall, you feel that her presence, what it's created around women's tennis,
I mean,
is a positive?
It's, she's not the most popular girl in the locker room, let's put it that way, because, but I think that's a little jealousy on behalf of the other players. She's getting most of the print, and it's not because of her tennis ability, it's because of the way she looks. But, I mean, she ended up the world number one in doubles, so she does have talent, and
30,
she still is a good role model. But this is what I mean. Both Williams sisters are on the same side of the court and just don't have, you know, lack that natural feeling as where to be at the right time.
Juice.
And Venus, we're still waiting for that letdown. She's, you know, to beat Martina Hingis, such a great three-set match, then to beat her sister, that must have, you know, obviously emotionally took a lot out of her. And then she has to come back today, the day before her singles finals, and yet get psyched up yet for another match.
This is the second straight Grand Slam where that's happened. As Venus puts it away at the French. Mary Pierce beat Martina Hingis in the semifinals, but then they paired up together, went on to win the doubles.
Right. Well, it feeds off of one another. You're so confident in singles.
Well, we're back with more women's doubles from Wimbledon. Yesterday at center court, the Williams sisters meeting head to head. There would not be any smiles after that. Chris, really seemed to be a match where once again neither sister played her best tennis.
Well, Serena, you know, she caught up. First of all, she slipped so many times. She should maybe get some new shoes the next time she plays on grass. I've never seen a player slip and slide so much on a dry grass court. But, you know, every time she caught up, all of a sudden you'd sense, oh, we're going to have a third set. They're going to play their best, and this could be really a magnificent match. But she, look at that, double final match point. She never lived up to her true potential in this match.
And the awkwardness of the moment never more evident than there on match point. A stunned moment where no one could believe it was over. Very emotional Serena. And one match after jumping for joy and beating Martina Hingis, Venus Williams did not look all that pleased herself.
They were both miserable.
But that was yesterday. And Richard Williams, the father, advised both girls to leave it on the court. And now they're back a day later as doubles partners here in the semifinals against Anna Kournikova and Natasha Zvereva.
All Grand Slam winners in doubles, all four of these women on this court. Kournikova owns one, Zvereva 18, and of course the Williams sisters 2.
One byproduct of yesterday's match is that Serena Williams' position, potential position on the Olympic team, is now in jeopardy.
It's a hard decision. Billie Jean King, the captain, has to make it by Monday. You're allowed 3 singles players to be on the team and 1 doubles team.
According to the computer rankings, the singles players will be Lindsay Davenport, Venus Williams, and Monica Seles. And the dilemma for Billie Jean King becomes that the number one ranked doubles player in the world right now is American Lisa Raymond.
Yeah, it's very tough. And then you know you're overlooking even Lindsay Davenport, Karina Moriarty, who were seeded 2 in this tournament, but they had to pull out because Karina was injured. I wouldn't want to be Billie Jean right now trying to make that decision. I mean, this team here this is their 3rd tournament all year. They're definitely not the most experienced doubles players, but if they come to win Wimbledon, I think you'd have an argument there. It's a frightening sight when you see both of them at the net because they're so tall, they have such wide reach, so tough to lob over. I think you have to try to get into the net first. See what Natasha does with this return.
Second serve.
Because you don't want to be one up and one back with both of them at the net, and they'd have a little target practice there.
Yeah, Martina Navratilova found that out.
She found that. She got hit twice by the Williams sisters, once in the arm, once in the head.
No. Yeah. And I think Kornikova was flinching there.
Yeah, it's...
3-3 games to 1 second set.
Just look in Serena's face today, Chris, and it's just a completely different look.
She looks better. I mean, she, you know, she probably had a whole night to sleep and to think about it. And, you know, it's true what they say. Their family is more important than tennis. Good for her that she can bounce right back after such an emotional loss. Oh, good volley. Natasha Zvereva, definitely the veteran, the more experienced player.
15-1.
She's crafty. She has such great finesse. She knows the right time to move. You remember a story back in 1989 at Hilton Head during a post-match on-court interview with Bud Collins. He presented her with a $40,000 runner-up and said, congratulations, what are you going to do with the money? Mm-hmm. And she said, actually, I don't get the money. The Russian Federation takes all my money. And after that, on national TV, within a year, all of a sudden the Russian Federation changed that whole rule, and then the Russian players, the Soviet players, started to receive their money. And, players like Chesnikov and all the other male players as well benefited from that one bold statement.
Does it seem like...
Well, we were all afraid when she went home what would happen to her. That is pretty bold. But she is very controversial and very outspoken and very popular with the players.
And just think, her partner, Anna Kournikova, is too young to even understand any of that.
Exactly.
From her own homeland.
Game is Kournikova.
So Kournikova and Zvereva hold.
The championships, Wimbledon, brought to you by Lincoln American Luxury, by the AIG companies, world leaders in insurance and financial services, by Oracle Software, powers the internet, and by Sealy Posturepedic. We support you night and day.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
The ladies' doubles semifinal on court one. Venus Williams serving. The Williams sisters up a break in the second.
Oh, Natasha, the more experienced one, putting the ball away. Anna was popping some easy volleys up there.
Love 15.
Just steps in and tries to close in on the net. Anna, of course, had a big fan in her third round match, jump and parade around the court. That's the streaker, the famous streaker. We had one here at Wimbledon, and it went on to Anna Kournikova's court.
15-0.
A professional streaker. He said that he claims that he had streaked 156 times in major events. And you could see Anna burying her head in the towel, pretending not to look, but she was definitely peeking.
30-50.
What I'm
I hope
curious
they show
about,
the clip. I hope NBC has enough guts to show that clip.
Well, Chris, now, the gentleman is a father of three. Now that's interesting dinner table conversation. What'd you do today,
Dad? I don't know.
My
husband's a father. He's a father of three too. So don't make any comparisons there. Well, he had painted on his chest. Mm-hmm. Only the ball should bounce, mm-hmm. and that's what her. She's over every billboard in England with that. When she's she has a sports bra that she's bringing out and mm-hmm. trying to give some publicity to, and I think he was obviously making reference to that billboard.
So double fault.
And it said in the paper, I actually mm-hmm. didn't see it, I wasn't on the court, but it said in the paper that he did a somersault over the net. So
this is far more
charming. Detail. Yeah, it's one of the more charming moments at Wimbledon. You can see Kournikova volleying, and you know, she's got quick hands, but just not a lot of weight behind the ball.
30-40.
You're so right. When that ball goes to Zvereva, boom, it's right,
right
back.
She clips it for a winner, but Kournikova just gets it in there.
Two doubles thrown in by Venus. And now, Chris asks and Chris gets. Let's see if we get the gymnastic streaker.
There, see, she's peeking. She's giving me a hard time. She's looking.
You're right. She's busted. A comical moment.
Wimbledon called it a harmless prank. Mm-hmm. They didn't arrest him or anything. And you know, the thing was, if you're watching Kournikova's match, you're not going to notice that someone's in the back of the court quickly stripping off their clothes. I mean, it was that's the match to do it, right? All eyes are on her. Oh, Kournikova finally cracked one.
Why does she have a little more success in doubles, Chris Kournikova, right now? Is it her hands?
I think it's her hands. I think there are certain players, very much like Natasha Zvereva, who also never lived up to her singles potential, mm-hmm. who need constant reinforcement and communication, and they're getting it. You can talk every single point. You can talk anytime you want. You know, whereas that. Obviously in singles, you can't have a coach on your court. So just, you know, more of a team person. Plus the fact she has a great return of serve, and that helps in doubles. Perfect. Usually the downfall in her game when she's playing doubles, when someone breaks serve, it's usually Kournikova's serve, because it is definitely the weaker serve. But that was a big first serve she just hit. And the second serve has always been more of a powder puff serve.
There you go. And you might say she's done a nice job of picking partners.
Yeah. Pingus, exactly. She's learned a lot from her partners. I mean, she's been, you know, she's picked more aggressive partners, more true serve and volleyers. And she was always placed in the same sentence as Serena Venus Williams and Martina Hingis a few years ago, and she is the only one that has not emerged into the top 10. The other ones have.
I had the rather unenviable task of calling a match years ago at the U.S. Open. I believe Kournikova was 12, Hingis was 13. They played each other in the
singles in the juniors, yeah.
And I believe it was Love. It was either Love or Love One.
I think it was Love and Love.
And it was just no contest. Why,
yeah, exactly.
Game is
almost an uncomfortable match to watch.
You lose, please, full change.
Hard to imagine a defending champion getting through a draw and going to a final with less attention than Lindsay Davenport. That's what's happened here at Wimbledon. But tomorrow morning, she will play Venus Williams for the Ladies' Championship. Breakfast at Wimbledon live coverage begins at 9 a.m. Eastern, 6 a.m. Pacific on NBC.
Lindsay's just that way, though. She doesn't demand attention like the other players. She's very happy to be in the background, let all the other players get all the press. Richard Williams watching us. Now he's here. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Where were you yesterday, Richard?
Well, Richard has said tomorrow will be a Williams party, and Lindsay's not invited. I think she may feel differently about that.
Oh, boy, I tell you, you know, this is not the time to get overconfident when you get Lindsay mm-hmm. Davenport in the finals of Wimbledon. As Steffi Graf found out last year, Steffi was the favorite. Lindsay's been quietly sneaking through the draw, getting better and better. Stronger and stronger. She's ready for Venus. Oh.
Serena.
Here, she's so close to the net. Good jump there by Serena.
Let first serve.
Serena does have a Wimbledon championship to her credit. She was a mixed doubles champ here in 1998, paired with Max Murnyi.
And this year, I don't believe either of them played in the mixed doubles. It's awfully hard to, if you know you're going to reach the semis or finals in the singles, it's hard to enter three events like that. Ooh.
40 love.
A lot of matches. If you enter three events and it rains and you get behind, sometimes you'll have three or four matches a day, and very often you'll see defaults, like you did last year when Steffi defaulted in the mixed with John McEnroe, and he wasn't very happy with anything that day. It was tough to work with.
So you found out too, huh?
I tried to defend Steffi mm-hmm. a little bit, saying, well, you know, she is playing the finals of the singles and she has her leg wrapped and
hopeless.
Yeah, it didn't go over very well. In the double tally. Look at this. Leaving the whole court open, but Serena got over there fast.
Four games old. Second.
See what I mean about it? You know, they don't really look like a really swift, sort of balanced doubles team. Usually protect your own territory, but they're all over the place, and it's succeeding.
Love 15.
What makes them such a great doubles team, though, is obviously their serves are almost unreturnable when they get their first serve in, but also their returns are great. And that's the whole thing in doubles. It's how you serve and how you return. And volleying might even come in third. And they're still very good volleyers. Whoa.
15-all.
Venus is probably saying, let's just get this set and get off the court because I really don't want to go a third. I've
right.
got a big match tomorrow. Oh. This will help their serve and volley and singles. You know, doubles is so good for a baseliner to play. I always encourage, you know, young girls to play a lot of doubles at a young age if they're baseliners, because it really forces you to volley. It forces you to go for a big first serve.
30.
Now, we've spoken a bit about this during Venus's singles matches, but you wonder if this experience here at Wimbledon in the finals and singles, playing well in doubles, will get her more comfortable playing serve and volley. Would you see it at the U.S. Open?
I would think so, if she's confident. I mean, what she needs to do is practice it in early rounds, in the first or second rounds, when she's winning 2-1.
Oh,
and we didn't, you know, we haven't seen that in early rounds, because if you don't practice it in a match under pressure, you know, you're certainly not going to reach the finals and all of a sudden come to the net and feel comfortable doing it. It won't be instinctive. So she needs to do it early on when she has easy matches and not be afraid to lose two or three games.
Missed there by Venus. Zvereva holds.
Thank you.
The Williams sisters in a tough battle here on court one in their ladies doubles semifinal. Venus Williams serving. Chris, if the Williams sisters win,
15-1.
They won't have to face the number one seed in the finals. The number one seeded team, Lisa Raymond and Renee Stubbs, have been knocked out.
And that's tough for Lisa Raymond, who, as you said before, is being considered for the Olympic team. That has to shake her confidence a little bit.
Julie Allard-Descougy and Ai Sugiyama, the team that in the semis has defeated Raymond and Stubbs.
They were seeded fourth in this tournament, so they had enough points, and those two are very good doubles players. I just can't see anyone getting by the power of these sisters.
I'm impressed in this set the way Kornikova's standing in there.
Yeah, she's just not afraid. She's just 13, holding her 15. Own, getting her the right footing. Reflexes are quick. This is a volley lob, which is a very effective shot. Well, these players are of the same generation. She's not intimidated by them.
It may not be ladylike, but I wonder, does she ever get smacked at in doubles? I mean, if there's resentment about what she's accomplished in terms of fame, this would be the scenario that someone might take a swing.
Now, what would make you think that, Ted?
Been listening to McEnroe tell me about this.
I don't think any of the players are that outright vicious.
They wouldn't
take
their aggression
smack
out that way,
at her.
Huh? Okay.
I think by mistake, like, you know, Martina got smacked twice by the Williams sisters. I don't think it was anything personal towards Martina. They all have their set of fans, though, don't they? A lot of electricity on that court. Hit that ball.
Okay, Miss Williams, Miss Williams.
So it's five all in the second set.
Five games all in the second set.
Well, now the Williams sisters will see if they can break.
Well, this would be the time to break, because her serve is very breakable. She's been broken before in this match.
Let her serve.
When it gets tight, she tends to double fault. If you watch her serve, she really doesn't have that nice natural rhythm. Things aren't working together.
15 long.
probably the most publicized woman athlete currently, wouldn't you say? I can't think of any other tennis player and athlete in any other sport that gets as much press as Anna.
Well, in our new age, she's clearly the queen of the web.
Right.
Something like 10,000 different websites that have at least some part devoted to her.
She's had Eric Van Harpen, her new coach, has worked with her since last September. And he was quoted as saying, you know, to get to the next level, Anna's really going to have to start to get down and dirty and think less about the image and about her off-court, you know, modeling and being in movies and more about, you know, the task at hand, getting into better shape and just becoming a better tennis player. You know, the question is, does she really want it badly? Because all the top players are so hungry. Or is she happy to be earning millions of dollars and being having that status?
Is there any relation to between what she's going through now and a player who broke in while you were still active in Gabriella Sabatini?
No comparison.
Obviously,
the publicity,
right.
I think, that is so much more. And
no question about that.
Gabby won some Grand Slam titles.
Well, she eventually
not only won tournaments, but she won some Grand Slam. This girl hasn't even won a tournament yet.
Right.
And she's on the covers of magazines like Sports Illustrated, so you have to wonder.
I was wondering, because at a young age, there was much more focus, again, on Gabriella Sabatini's look and image, perhaps, than on her tennis. Not to this degree,
no. Not to this worldwide degree of every newspaper cover in the world, and, as you said, the website. Just doesn't have the weight of the ball behind her. Not in the same class, really, as Serena and Venus.
Game is Sonakota, Miss Silva.
So we'll come back, and the Williams sisters will try to get this set into a tiebreak. Back on court one, ladies doubles semifinals. And Serena Williams now will try to get the Williams sisters into a tiebreak and a chance to close out this match.
Oh, good volley exchange at the net. Quick hands from Serena. Venus is probably telling her sister, you know, I really like to be back at the house right now, you know, watching a video and away from Wimbledon and the pressures. Let's just try to win this second set, get it to a tiebreaker and win it. The day before a final, you just don't want to be out here for 3 hours if you can help it. She was right there, too, Serena. The ball went right into her racket. The more muscular of the two, certainly. When I hadn't seen Venus for a while because she was off with injuries in both of her wrists, when she came back, I thought she looked really lean and trim. And
30-50.
Well, I thought Tina Navratilova's comparison was the best, who, of course, herself at her time was a very strong, muscular player. She said she walked in the locker room with the Williams sisters and she felt like a pipsqueak.
40-50.
Martina's, you know, she's 5'7", and she looks quite short compared to them. Up next, she looked pretty small on that court yesterday. Still has the hands, though. I bet you she'd be quicker at the net than they would be at this stage in their careers.
Yeah. Yay, Miss Williams.
Oh, good game by the Williams sisters. And now the second set will go to a tiebreak.
Second set tiebreak.
Good pickup volley there. Right down the middle. That's a good play in doubles.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
First served is Zvereva.
sort of the obvious place right here. Anna really should have been watching that down the line. This would have been a perfect place to hit that ball. The obvious place, I think. Going to move over a few inches when you see that could happen. And then Bina should have watched the middle a little bit better.
So 2-0, Miss Williams.
This is when you really want to get your first serve in, the tiebreaker, because you know the end is near. Every point is like a match point. And they get free points and cheap points when they get their big first serves in. Oh. Well, she took off. She was going to poach for that shot.
2-1.
Venus hit a good first serve. It was a good time, but it was just a little bit too much of an angle. Then she got caught. That swinging forehand shot from Zvereva.
And Kornikova to serve.
That ball had a lot of spin on it, and it dipped, forcing Anna to hit up. Anna wasn't into the net close enough.
Just prior to serve, please be quiet. Thank you.
I think what he's talking about is during the point. Too good.
4-1, Miss Williams.
That second serve just sits up perfectly, doesn't it? She's way inside the baseline.
Say she's 15 feet inside hitting that ball. So now the Williams sisters in command. The Williams sisters are 2 points from the doubles final. Tonight, our final edition of the Wimbledon Update. 30-minute edition tonight, 11:35 p.m. Eastern and Pacific. All the highlights of Andre Agassi and Pete Sampras in the semis, all followed by the Tonight Show with Jay Leno.
Miss Williams.
And their second serves have a lot of zip to it and a lot of spin, a lot of racket head speed at the top.
So match points forever for the Williams.
Very safe lead right here.
Miss Williams.
Venus was thinking about that massage she was going to get after this match. She's going to have to wait another point.
Miss Williams.
So the Williams now will try to close it out on their serve.
Oh, wow, a good comeback from Zvereva Kornikova. They're holding their own pretty well. Still down though. Couple more match points. Kornikova probably hoping that streaker maybe would come back and distract the sisters a little bit more.
Well, Venus needs to blast one serve in here. To the body of Zvereva. So a nice little casual day before the final for Venus Williams, but the sisters are through. And they will now meet Julie Allard Desfougies and Ai Sugiyama for the ladies' doubles final here at Wimbledon. It has been indeed a Williams family party for this fortnight. And we'll see Venus again tomorrow in breakfast at Wimbledon. More when our coverage continues on NBC.
Our Morgan Stanley Dean Witter point of the day comes in the fifth set of the brilliant semifinal match between Rafter and Agassi. A dive by Pat Rafter, and the point is good. En route to his five-set victory over the second seed. So good, we'll give you another look at it. Andre Agassi rips one from the baseline. Perfectly timed leap by Rafter. A great effort, typical of the play by both players during the match. Our Morgan Stanley Dean Witter point of the day. And so Pat Rafter goes on to the final to meet Pete Sampras, who eliminated the qualifier today, Vladimir Volchkov, in straight sets. That match is Sunday. Saturday belongs to the women's championship. Tomorrow it's an All-American showdown as Venus Williams meets Lindsay Davenport for the ladies' championship. Davenport celebrated here last year, capturing her first Wimbledon title in grand style over seven-time champion Steffi Graf. Tomorrow she faces an opponent she is 8-3 against and has never lost to in a grand slam.
She always has such a great serve, and I found the key to a lot of the victories is getting her serve back and making her feel a little bit bad about her serve. But that is going to be a lot tougher on the grass because it stays a lot lower and is much faster.
Williams has had an emotional week. Jubilant after upsetting top-ranked Martina Hingis in the quarterfinals on Tuesday to advance to her first semifinal here. Then yesterday, in the most anticipated match of the tournament thus far, a family affair battling younger sister Serena for family bragging rights. Not to mention a spot in the final. This time, celebration was not so jubilant for Venus, but she is just one victory away from her first Grand Slam.